My name is Ashanti Golar, and I'm the director of the Democratic National Committee's Youth Council. I have the amazing job of walking into the Democratic Party headquarters every day and working with college Democrats and young people from across the country. It is an honor for me to be here today with Chairman Kaine and the George Washington University College Democrats. So many young people turned out to vote for the first time in 2008. Our efforts made Barack Obama the 44th president of the United States. And as our president, he hasn't disappointed us. From reforming the federal student loan program and making college more affordable, to enacting healthcare legislation that allows you to stay on your parents' insurance until the age of 26, and most recently with credit card reform, President Obama is fighting hard to make our lives better. This year, in order to build upon these accomplishments, we need to ensure that college Democrats, young people from across the country, and 2008 first-time voters come out again and support President Obama and Democrats in November. It won't be easy, and we can't do it alone. We need for you to continue to be active. Go out there and vote, knock on doors, and make phone calls. Political activism starts with voting. Outside on the table, we have pledge cards. Before each of you leave today, we ask that you fill out the card and commit to vote in November. We also have volunteers walking around with clipboards. They can give you a pledge card, and they can also sign you up to volunteer. With up to 100,000 members and over 1,000 chapters across the country, I ask that every college Democrat get involved with the campaigns in their state. We have to make sure that we continue to make a difference. Vote. Sign up to volunteer. Sign up 5 friends to volunteer. We need to elect our Democrats. Thank you all so much, and it's now my pleasure to introduce Josh Altman, the president of the George Washington University College Democrats.
Thank you. Hello, my name is Josh Altman, and I'm the president of the George Washington College Democrats, and it is on behalf of the College Democrats that I would like to extend the warmest of welcomes to all of you today. Before we begin, I would like to extend a special thank you to our Vice President, Nate Perkins, who did a great job working with the DNC and GW staffs. I would like to thank them as well for putting together this tremendous event. I'd also like to thank my e-board, who is the finest collection of young Democrats I've ever had the pleasure of associating myself with. Each and every year, the GW College Democrats energetically embrace the philosophy that through our activism and engagement, young people can have an impact. Through campaign trips, trainings, and speakers, we strive to harness the energy of young people to keep them engaged in the political process. I'm proud to be a Democrat, and it is a thrill and an honor to stand here as a young person who helped President Obama get elected in 2008. But I also stand up here knowing that our work is not yet done. Young people like us helped elect President Obama, and it must be young people like us that keep the fight alive. We know President Obama has fought hard for us, and we know we are going to fight hard for him, because we know that he stands for the ideas that drive our passion for political engagement. You see, the GW College Democrats are motivated by an idea that underlies this administration and the Democratic Party in general. It's an idea that drew me into this party and made me a supporter of the candidacy and administration of Barack Obama. The idea that we are not a party restricted to any one type of person or group or personality, but we are a party of Americans who believe in the power of ideas, who believe that the dogmas of the quiet past are inadequate to the stormy present, that a complex world demands thoughtful and complex solutions, and that, as Bobby Kennedy once said long ago, as long as men are hungry and children uneducated and their welfare destroyed by pestilence, that long will the American Revolution not be finished. We see these ideals at work when we look at the achievements of the past year and a half, and it becomes clear how much the Democratic Party fights for students. With the passage of health care reform, we can now stay on our parents' insurance until we're 26. Student loan reform means that young people don't have to worry about prohibitive costs that follow them for the rest of their lives going through after college. And credit card reform, passed by a Democratic Congress, guarantees that credit card companies can no longer take advantage of students. We've accomplished so much in the last year and a half, yet there is still so much to do. That's why I'm asking every Democrat, every student, every citizen to support your local Democrats, volunteer on a campaign, and turn out the vote for those candidates who will represent our generation and the interests of our country. It was students who made the difference in 2008, and now we've been called upon to make a difference in 2010. So with that, it is with great pleasure that I, on behalf of the GW College Democrats, have the honor of introducing today's speaker. He served 7 years on the Richmond City Council, 2 as the 76th mayor of Richmond, and 4 as the 70th governor of the Commonwealth of Virginia. Let's welcome the chairman of the Democratic National Committee, Governor Tim Kaine.
Thank you all very much. Wow, this is great. Hello, G-Dub. Oh, this is very, very good. Well, I want to thank you all for gathering today for an exciting announcement. Let me start by thanking Josh for his great words on behalf of our party, for the kind introduction to you and your colleagues with the George Washington Young Democrats. You do a great job. Give Josh and all the GW Young Dems a big round of applause. We're honored to be here at George Washington. Provost Steve Lerman and the entire GW team has been extremely generous. They do events for Democrats, Republicans, libertarians, vegetarians, cultural events. You guys are a wonderful host, and we always feel so welcome when we're here on the GW campus. And we've got an incredible crowd. I hear we even have an overflow room of people who are here, so that is a great, great thing. It's great to know that you represent millions of Democrats across the country who are active in our party, in our proud, in our energetic, in our enthusiastic party. You know, our Democratic family is huge. In fact, more than 75 million Americans call themselves Democrats. And they're from all walks of life, in all regions. I've traveled now to more than 40 states as a DNC chair, and I can tell you this, if you walk into a Democratic meeting anywhere in the United States, you're going to find somebody like you. That diversity, that Big Ten, is what makes America great, and it's what makes our country great, our party great. There's no single picture of the Democratic Party, who a Democrat is. Our party is both large and diverse. Ever since Andrew Jackson, at his inaugural here in Washington, threw open the doors of the White House to the American public, the Democratic Party has been the party of the people. As Democrats, we're united by a common aspiration to make our country better, not just for a few select individuals, but for all Americans. We want to win, but more importantly, we want to serve. We want to do what it takes so that middle-class Americans, workers, families, and small businesses can get ahead. We know how to make government work for the people. Because of that, voters have always turned to Democrats when the times get tough. They turned to Democrats in the 1930s, when in the midst of a Great Depression, they elected President Franklin Roosevelt to lead us forward. They turned to us in the 1960s, when they elected President Kennedy to tackle complex challenges of a new era. They turned to Democrats in the 1990s, when they elected President Clinton to get the American economy moving again and bring national debt under control. And in one of the most historic elections in our nation's 220-plus years, they turned to Democrats in 2008, when they elected our president, President Barack Obama, to halt America's slide into a second Great Depression and restore our standing in the world. And wasn't that a magnificent night? I still get goosebumps thinking about that night, and more particularly thinking about all that went up over generations and generations and generations for us to be able to get to that night. Voters turn to Democrats looking for change, and over again, we've delivered change that matters. Social Security, Medicare, women's suffrage, the minimum wage, GI Bill, the Civil Rights Acts, the Voting Rights Act, Equal Pay, Family and Medical Leave Act, balancing the federal budget. I could go on and on. Time and again, through those changes and others, Democrats renewed the promise of America and laid that stronger foundation for everyday Americans, our families, middle-class citizens, and small businesses, so that we can have prosperity. Time and again, Democrats, even when it wasn't easy, even when it wasn't popular, did what was needed to help Americans from all walks of life get ahead, even in the face of tough Republican opposition. President Harry Truman, and I loved that video earlier that you all saw, had a phrase for the Republican Party. He called them the Do-Nothing Party. Now, it's been more than 50 years since President Truman said that in the late 1940s, but the name still has an uncanny ring to it. And you know what? The American people, they don't want a do-nothing party, and they don't want do-nothing leaders. They want a party and leaders that is going to do something about the challenges that they face in their daily lives and the challenges that we all face as a nation. That's why this year, despite the challenges we continue to face as a nation, I think voters will want to keep moving forward with Democrats who are bringing about change that matters. Because in the end, Americans don't want to go backwards. I travel around, I talk to people everywhere. People are hurting in this country and they see enormous challenges, but I could go into an auditorium of 100,000 people and ask, how many of you want to go backwards into a lost decade where America lost jobs, where families had less income at the end than at the start, and the poverty gap widened? No one wants to go backwards. Thank you. Americans don't want leaders whose vision for the future is to go back to the same failed policies that put us into a lost decade. They don't want leaders who will cut taxes for the super wealthiest, cut regulations for the special interest, and cut middle-class Americans loose to fend for themselves. Right? Americans don't want leaders who are going to roll back the clock, not just on the last year or two, but in some instances roll back the clock on decades worth of positive change that we fought hard to achieve. Americans want to go forward, and the Democratic Party is the party that will take this country forward. That's what we're about. That's what we're about. That's what we're about, moving America forward. And that's why we're delivering the change that matters for Americans now. We, the Democrats, delivered the Recovery Act for hardworking Americans who found themselves jobless through no fault of their own, and for middle-class families who lost ground over a decade of failed leadership and then took a giant step backward when the economic crisis hit home. That's why we did the Recovery Act, and we have an economy that was shredding and shedding 750,000 jobs a month that is now growing again. A GDP that was shrinking that is now growing again. You know, 8 months in a row, private sector job growth. We know we now have to go from decline to growth and more positive growth. We know we have to do that, but it was Democrats who delivered on economic recovery when virtually a united Republican congressional membership voted against economic recovery in the worst economy since the 1930s. We as Democrats delivered the Affordable Care Act for children with pre-existing medical conditions, for families priced out of the insurance market by the rising cost of care, for small businesses struggling to find ways to provide health insurance for their valued employees. It was Democrats who delivered the Affordable Care Act, and we'll be talking about that as a signature achievement for generations to come. And it was Democrats who delivered the biggest expansion of Pell Grants and student loans in the history of this country with an act that was passed earlier this year. America used to be number one in the world in the percentage of our adults that had 2, 4, or qualified technical degrees. We're now 12th or 13th in the world, and a whole series of other nations are scaling up fast while our higher ed attainment rate has been flat. There is not going to be a place at the top of the tough competitive global economy for nations that are 15th or 20th or 30th in terms of adults with higher ed degrees, and part of the issue is the challenge in the affordability of a college education. And if it wasn't Democrats out battling for that, it wouldn't have happened. So that's a promise that President Obama made on the campaign trail, and we've delivered on, and it's going to benefit thousands of students. We delivered Wall Street reform for American taxpayers who shouldn't have to pay the bets of big banks, for American business owners who deserve a chance to grow their companies and need access to capital to do it, and for American workers who deserve a chance to get back on their feet. That's change that matters, folks. That's change that matters. And whether it's more low-income children with health insurance or whether it's two great new women on the U.S. Supreme Court, or whether it's equal pay for equal work for women, or whether it's the stop of combat operations in Iraq, again and again, the Democrats are delivering change that matters. But as Josh said, the fight isn't over. We've got to keep fighting. We've got to keep fighting for change because we're not out of the woods yet. We've got to keep fighting for progress, for a better country, and a brighter future. So, without further ado, I'd like to unveil the new symbol of today's Democratic Party, Democrats delivering the change that matters.
Through 200 years of heartache and hope, through struggle and progress, Democrats have fought to make the changes that matter most to the American people. Democrats are the party of Jefferson, who declared that we are all created equal, and we've worked long and hard to make that real. We welcomed immigrants to our shores, opened railroads to the West, and pathways to education and opportunity. Democrats are the party of Roosevelt, who showed us that all we had to fear was fear itself.
Fear itself!
And so we help lead our country back from depression with a new deal, new jobs, and a new sense of common purpose. Democrats are the party of Truman, who helped defeat fascism, preserve democracy, and rebuild in the aftermath of war. Democrats are the party of Kennedy, who summoned us to serve and challenged us to dream.
I have a dream.
The things that make us Democrats are the things that made America what it is today. That's who we are. We don't fear the future. We shape it.
We came here to shape it.
The history of our country is a history of change. And the history of Democrats is the history of change that matters for America.
So what do you think?
All right.
Change that matters. In 50 years when they renovate this building, a t-shirt went up over the one of the roof tiles that they will find and they'll remember we were here on this great day. We're very excited about the updated new look for the party, and I want to thank everybody in the party and all those that they've talked to across the country over many months to develop this look, but more importantly, the tools, and that's what I want to talk about now. We're proud of what we've accomplished, excited about identifying ourselves as Democrats who have delivered and will keep delivering change that matters. We as Democrats create that change. We're the party of ideas and ideals, of policies and of people, of history and of purpose. Our party includes great Democrats like Claudia Lopez Schultz of Arizona. Claudia immigrated to America, and on the day she was naturalized, registered to vote, and then registered her entire family to vote on the same day, who then went out and urged others to do the same, and who's been volunteering for the Democratic Party ever since, because in her words, it doesn't matter who you are, you're welcome. Claudia. People like Claire White, a local volunteer from D.C. who is here today. Claire has been a fixture at Democratic campaign offices election after election, helping to elect real change makers at every level of government. Round of applause for Claire. And Greg Myers of Pennsylvania. Greg has worked incredibly hard on behalf of Democratic candidates in his state who listened when President Obama promised, "Together we will change this country and change this world," believed it, and who has been working for that change ever since. To all our volunteers, a great round of applause. They are the lifeblood of our party. The new identity of the party captures that spirit and unites us all. Democrats, all of us, working for the changes that matter. In conjunction with that work, I'm also proud to announce today that we are launching a new action-oriented website for the Democratic Party. Throughout history, we have worked from the ground up to bring about change that matters, and we have tried to be innovative in using the best tools at the most up-to-date moment to do that. The look and feel of the new updated website reflects that commitment to local grassroots organizing. The website will foster not only party-initiated activism, but also organic political action. The new www.democrats.org gives Democrats cutting-edge tools that will empower people across the country to connect with one another and also with the party and with candidates at both the local, state, and national levels. Here's what it means. On our new front page, when you log into democrats.org, one of the first things you're going to see right up front is a list of your local Democratic candidates. So it'll come up differently in different parts of the country because we want it to be personalized to you and the races that you care about based on where you log on. The localization of our website is a key advance that will help Americans to connect directly with their local candidates and also with both campaigns and local parties, efficiently channeling them toward action on behalf of Democratic causes and candidates. This will pay immediate dividends to voters, and we're rolling it out now because we know people will want to look at it and make those connections with candidates between now and Election Day. Voters and supporters will also find campaign contact information, how to volunteer, how to donate, how to do a phone bank in your own home and make calls on behalf of candidates. You'll find information on events that are being done both by candidates and your state and local parties. You'll find how to register to vote, or if you need to check the status of your registration, precinct, and other information, you can find that. And you can find that all in a way that will help us make a difference for our candidates this year. This information, this local information that's action-oriented will be among the first things that you see when you come to us. If you want to stick around for a little bit after the program, our new media team at the DNC is second to none, is going to walk through the site in greater detail. And I hope that some of you might take a few moments to explore the website on your own. And if there's one more thing you can take away from today, I hope it's this. Today's Democratic Party is ready to use every single tool in the toolbox and build new tools to help the president and Democratic leaders continue to move this country forward. Because we know there is so much more work to done. For all the advances we've made, we can list other issues, and if the president were here, he'd say the same thing. Other issues where we need to keep moving forward, and we can't afford to now give in to forces of obstruction or delay or going backwards. Right? In the difficult periods of our history, Democrats always have dreamed of a brighter future. In the face of our biggest challenges, Democrats have always dreamed and fought for even bigger solutions, greater security for American people and expanding opportunity for all Americans. That's why I'm so proud to be a Democrat. I grew up in Kansas City. When I was a young boy, when we heard Democrat, what we thought about was the man from Independence, that suburb of Kansas City where Harry Truman lived. And Harry Truman was still alive when I was growing up and would go to the Truman Library and would interact with student groups who came over and talked to them about the greatness of our country and the greatness of our party. He was a local hero. I got a sense from him and from others about what the Democratic Party stood for. We're the party that stands tall around the world and pushes for greater equality at home. We're the party that promotes American achievement, yet is always looking out with special care for those in need. We're the party that stands up every day for all Americans, for a brighter future, and for the American dream. That's our party, and we're proud of it. We are Democrats, and we are delivering the change that matters. Thank you all very much, and have a great day.